these two types of polycales. One was polycap, other one is a polycale. There are some differences, but the minimum dose that is required for to have an antiplatelet effect, clinically relevant antiplatelet effect, is 5 milligrams. And if you notice that in that study of 100 milligrams, your enteric-coated aspirin and not the regular without soluble aspirin. And one of the reasons is that for giving 100 milligrams.
The other thing is simvastatin. Usually the pleurotherapeutic effect, stabilizing of the plaque, is with 40 mg, not with 20 mg, with simvastatin. So we are giving also simvastatin less.
Well, that's why I said that if the desired effect is not seen on the respective risk factors like lipid levels or the blood pressure levels, instead of giving one capsule per day, we can give two capsules per day. But in the other polypill, they are trying to combine 40 milligrams of the simvastatin. But they are not combining atenolol or not combining atenolol with erythropoietin. So, for secondary prevention of coronary artery disease, a beta blockers go a long way in preventing a second attack, at least in the first 5 years after the attack. So, in that combined trial, what they did was they did not use atenolol in some of the groups, and they used only erythropoietin as an antihypertensive agent, but not for secondary prevention. So there are some, we are still in the process of evolution, let me put it that way, that we are trying to experiment with the drugs, with the doses of the drugs, with the number of drugs, and the various combinations of. So the trials are on, like HOPE-3, HOPE-4, trials are on, which will probably show finally which dosage of the drugs suddenly end up in a decrease in the clinical vascular events. Ultimately, what the patient wants.
When I referred the case to a cardiologist, he said make atenolol 100, beta blocker 100. So I just added another 50 to that. Except hydrochlorothiazide and aspirin, probably whatever drug you want. If you want to add another 20 mg simvastatin, you can add. You are always at liberty. But the thing is, drug compliance is one thing. Patients are so happy. I wish you had some patients here to talk about the pill and how happy they are ever since we started this pill. So because, you know, they are psychologically getting affected. If they take, already we put about 3 drugs for the diabetes and about another 5 drugs, 8 drugs as a single pill if they take, their psychology is so changed, and I'm having such a big disease. It's not only he, the children, and the wife, and everybody. Now he takes, I'm just taking one single pill. That's all, I'm so happy. This is the actual reaction of the patients. And then, whatever you want to add, when we read the necessity for a particular molecule, we can always add it. But it's doing wonderfully well, and above all, it's for one simvastatin tablet in India, we are getting a polypill. That's why it's so easy and it's so economical to also. That's my observation actually.
So since it contained 5 tablets, I'm in the new cardiologist, just now passed out. I find it difficult in prescribing it, because we have to rule out this bradycardia or some heart block, then we have to rule out diabetes, since hydrochlorothiazide will increase the blood sugar. Then ramipril, which is a ACE inhibitor, we have to rule out any renal function. What do you say about this?
Very true that you can't prescribe a drug and then forget about it. We need to monitor the biochemical aspects of it. And you have to be careful in some patients about usage of individual drugs, like heart rate in, when you're prescribing a beta blocker, and a serum creatinine and serum potassium when you're prescribing an ACE inhibitor, and aspirin when you're considering a patient who has got an active bleeding ulcer. So there are some exceptions, but by and large, if you take the bulk of the coronary artery disease or a vascular disease patient, at least in our country, we have at least 2 risk factors or more. And for better compliance, I think I've shown you the slide that the lesser the compliance, the lesser is the benefit. So if you really want to have the maximum benefit by the drug therapy, you need to put all the four drugs and without missing a single drug. A lot of studies have been done that the more the number of tablet the patient has to swallow, is likely to forget at least one, no matter how motivated the patient is. This is a fact of life. So if you can make the pill number at least, that is one, probably the compliance rate will be high. And in these studies of TIPS 1 and TIPS 2, it has been shown that the compliance rate is anywhere from 75% to 80%. Agreed, it is not 100%, but it's still 75% to 80%. As compared to only 10% to 15% in the pure study, where people have to spend four separate tablets. And only 10% have been taking all the four tablets. So, to show that it is effective in bringing down the inconvenience.
Sir, in support of your evolution, as you were repeatedly telling, just 2 years back, this polypill was coming to 10 tablets pack. Actually, in Barcelona, I was sitting with Dr. Modi. And then I told him, you must give a calendar pack. I just draw on a sketch. Then he called his CEO, Mr. Pasuthan, what is the CEO? Medical director, huh? CEO. Then he said, three of us sat. I just put one pack of 15 pills and then put the number of dates on that. And then we have spent half an hour on that. The moment I told him that we need a calendar pack so that they will not miss the packet, as is the compliance is too good and we are pushing 5 drugs in one shot. And then if we have this non-forgettability by having the calendar pack, and today what you are seeing in the market is actually that how much you are changing constantly. That's the day, it was in just Barcelona, we were all sitting before the meeting and we spent half an hour on that exactly, and today the calendar pack is in the market. So that means it is going to take further, probably some doses also may change, some may be added also. As you said, I think it will definitely withstand the evolution in future also.
Thank you, sir. Yes.
What I found in my practice also is, first month the patient takes all the drugs and then he comes after 2-3 months and he takes only the diabetic pill or the hypertension. If he is not hypertensive, he takes only the hypertension pill. He leaves all the things as if they are not important. Once the blood pressure, I am taking blood pressure medicine. So for compliance, this is a very good thing, and of course the rate also has come down. It's a blessing in disguise.
Thank you very much for this grand discussion. I think the consensus that I saw emerging, I think without any doubt, there are three things that Polycan can stand for. One is, it is a definite solid evidence by science about its own in second intervention. It reduces the pill burden and so improves the compliance. And third, as the doctor said, it is a boon for cost-sensitive patient, because if you give individual tablets versus one polycan, it still works out 30% cheaper. But the most important thing you rightly brought up, that the concept was brought by British doctors, British scientists, back in 2003. But I want you to realize that it was an Indian company which could put this in progress. And that is what innovation in India is all about. There was no British or European or American company which could formulate it. It is not as simple as putting all the required ingredients in one pill. So it was an Indian company, and the only Indian company in the world which brought this up. And that is what we are celebrating. A lot of work, a lot of hard work has gone behind making this wonder drug, which is unique in Canada, and we are very proud of this wonder drug as an innovative product coming from Indian company for the first time in the world. It is really a moment of great pride and great honor for us, and we are really grateful to all the cardiologists, all the doctors sitting here for positively supporting this concept, and we have definitely taken into account the suggestions that has been given, and we look forward to your continued support on this wonder drug.